the name of Jesus. No other name. No other name. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name. No other name. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name.
I'm sick of theology and words. We need God to move in our midst. O thou that dwellest between the cherubims, Lord, don't stay there. Come down here. The one thing that alarms me in America and England is that there is no alarm in the church. You say America needs God. No, she doesn't. The church needs God. If the church gets God, America will soon feel it. She'll be staggering.
A preacher said something the other day that's very disturbing to an audience that he was addressing. He said, I want to tell you that if God withdrew the Holy Spirit from my church today, it would function tomorrow the same way. We wouldn't even know he'd gone. And methinks that might be written of many churches, in that we become so mechanical. We go in at 11 and come out at 12, and the Holy Ghost must come when we open the door of the church, and he must leave when we lock it. And we try and lay down the track and say, come Holy Ghost, for thee we call, Spirit of burning, come, but come our way. We've laid down the conditions. Holy Ghost, come, but please don't violate our theology. Don't upset our status quo. Don't break our hearts over a lost world. Oh, yes, yes, preachers. You and I will raise our hats to Finney and Gould, and we raise our hats to the martyrs, and we thank God for the last drop of their blood, but we won't give him the first drop of ours.
I can't live another day without the fire of God consuming me, everything that's un-Christ-like, consuming me, everything which hinders. Surrender everything. That's revival. When you can't sit through the meeting, you feel you've got a burning cancer. If I don't get to the cross now, I may die before the meeting's over. Every preacher who has lost the fire, you should be on your face down here. You used to burn, but you got so busy with organizing. The fire has gone out. Come on. You can't patch up your prayer life when you get to the judgment seat. You can't sacrifice when you get to the judgment seat. You can't weep when you get to the judgment seat. It's all between here and there. Listen, if our God is a consuming fire, and he is, if he takes up residence in you, you'll burn till you die. God needs a torch of holy fire in your house. He wants a fire in you to read the word of God to your family. He wants the fire of God your neighbors will know. I can't live in coldness anymore. I can't live in blindness anymore. I can't be indifferent to a dying world. Yes. Glory. Glory to God. Thank you, Father.
He makes all things new.
If you want revival, scream!
Scream if you want revival. If you're ready to jump in the fire, just come on and jump in. But I'm going to give you a little tip on what you're going to have to do to get revival. The sleeping people's going to have to wake up. Lukewarm people's going to have to fire up in the name of Jesus. Dishonest people's going to have to fast up. Disgruntled people's going to have to cheer up. Estranged people's going to have to cheer up. Gossipers are going to have to shut up. I'm going to tell you right now, dry bones are going to have to shake up in the name of Jesus. Soldiers are going to have to stand up. Then we can have a revival. Then we're going to see more lost people getting saved up. We're going to see sick people getting healed up. We're going to see captives getting freed up. Let me tell you something. We're going to see more people getting filled up with the Holy Ghost. Shut up. I'm going to read it one more time. Jess has done read it. But there's one prophecy that ain't been filled. And he says, it shall come to pass in my last days, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaids, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they shall prophesy. And I will shew wonders in heaven above and signs of the earth beneath, blow, blood, and fire, and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon into blood before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I'm going to tell you right now, you've got to be willing to sacrifice a few things. Whoa, you've got to be willing to put a few things to the side. I'm going to tell you right now, here's a little old-timey preaching. The best thing I ever done was took off the old coat and I put on the new. And right now, that revival is time to put on the new coat. Right now, it's revival. Don't stand back and watch it go. Jump in the fire. Praise him for a minute.
Don't sit down. Don't sit down. We have only just begun. Go ahead, put your hands together. Give him some praise.
When I call your name, something happens. When I call your name, something happens. When I call your name, something happens. When I call your name.
If you need something to happen in your life tonight, all you gotta do is call on his name.
Mountains move when I call your name. Mountains move when I call your name. Mountains move when I call your name. I call your name. Chains are loose when I call your name. Chains are loose when I call your name. Chains are loose when I call your name.
Y'all ready for some breakthrough tonight? All you gotta do is call on his name and we are gonna break through. Let me hear it. Are you ready for breakthrough?
We break through.
We break through when we call your name. 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 We break through when we call your name.
I gotta praise and I gotta get it out. Amen, amen, amen. How many is happy to be here tonight? Amen. Amen. We can do better than that. How many is happy to be here tonight? That's better. That's better. That's better. That's better. Ushers, if you'll come forward. It says in the Word of God that if we give, like Pastor preached on this morning, if we give, it will be given back to us. Now, the way it's given back to us is it's going to be shaken together a little bit. It's going to be pressed together and then pouring out. That which you give will be given unto you. So if you want to give unto God, and I'll tell you right up front, you cannot outgive God. And he likes it when you try. So go ahead and try. It brings a little tickle to him. Go ahead and try to outgive him. But if you want to see it come back to you, give all that you got. Give your portion, because it will come back to you. And when it does, it's going to be packed in. It's going to be shaken together. And when it pours out, see, he's making more room for more to give unto you. And then it'll be poured out unto your bosom. Amen? Let's get our tithing off and ready. Father God, we thank you so much for what you've done for us. God, we thank you for this time in worship. We thank you for this time to come into your presence. God, you are amazing. We thank you, Father, for your word that you've given us. Malachi 3 and 10, Heavenly Father, you said if we bring our tithes and offerings into the storehouse, Lord, that there would be meat in your house. God, that you would open up the windows of heaven and pour out blessings that we can't even contain. We can't even contain them, God. You said that you would rebuke the devourer. You said you won't allow our fruit to fall from the vine before its time. God, we thank you for your promises. We thank you for your covenants, God. We thank you for the word that you've given us, Lord. We thank you. Lord, we give our tithes. We give our offerings to you tonight, dear Heavenly Father, with a grateful heart, with an expecting heart, God, of what you're going to do here tonight, because this is just a continuation of worship, and that's how we're going to worship you tonight, God. We're giving it to you. In Jesus' name, receive it. Amen. Amen.
Cartoon from your childhood, or you might smell a food that you used to eat when you were little, and it just brings back memories and it's nostalgic. That right there is nostalgic for me. That's what I grew up listening to every time we took up the offering, and it just warms my heart. While you're up, go hug somebody, shake a hand, find somebody new, introduce yourself.
to worship with us again.
There's a people crying out from the ends of the earth. We know your spirit is moving, still we hunger and thirst. There's a sound that's rising from the church, no longer satisfied with dryness, so we look to you, Lord. You said, I swore it.
Open this atmosphere. Spirit of the Lord says, you ask for my rain. What you don't understand is that when I rain, it don't just get wet. It becomes saturated. I will bring you saturation. Every fiber of your being will be saturated by my Spirit. You're not just going to get a little wet here and there. You won't be able to tell what was dry what is wet. I will saturate you. Your entire being will be saturated with my Spirit. I'm coming. My rain is coming. You keep asking because it's coming. And I'm bringing the rain. I'm bringing the flood. I'm bringing my Spirit to your dry land.
For this is the place. Look around. Look around. Look at your brothers and your sisters. This is the place. The place of unity. The place with hearts of flesh where God will command his blessing. The body of Christ, one heart, one mind, worshiping God. That is the place where he declares he will command his blessing. Not so you can use it on yourself, but so you can take it out to the lost, the hurting, the broken, the discouraged, and show them his light and his life. This is the place of blessing.
Let it rain. Open.
Listen to me, listen to me. God's saying, you've got that word shower stuck in your head. I never said shower, God said. You'll not find that in my word. No word is to say shower that I'm sending you. In your English, you'll say torrential. It will be a torrential rain. And the rain won't stop until I come back, until the harvest time. The rain will continue. Read my word. The rain will stay until the harvest is complete. The rain will not go away. God said, get the shower out of your head. It's not temporary. It's permanent rain until harvest season. It's torrential. In our English terms, torrential is the word we need to speak. Not shower. don't want to miss the Lord tonight, Brother Brad. I heard the Spirit say that they in the world speak death, but the Lord says, I am life. You may have debt, but I am life. You may have pain, but I am life. You may be surrounded by dry bones, but I'm still the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord.
Yeah.
mercy seat. Somebody thank him for the mercy seat. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Well, I wish someone in this house would stand to your feet. If you've ran to that mercy seat and you've been washed, come on. Let somebody know that you've been redeemed. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Lord, we bless you, magnify you, healer, redeemer, savior. Come on, somebody. Soon coming king. Oh, we bless you, mighty God. Faithful one, righteous one. Lord, we bless you. Praise you. Thank you, Holy Ghost baptizer. God, we, hey, hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless you, mighty God. Well, I need somebody, I need a witness that'll say he's faithful. I need a witness in here that says, my God is faithful. He's never early, but he's never late. Come on, he's a right on time God. And there's a right time word about to be delivered tonight. Right, come on, somebody. A right now word, and we're thankful for it tonight. Thank you, mighty God. Brother John, would everybody put your hands together for a pastor? Come on. Come on. Let this brother know you love him. Come on.
God's anointing fire within you, brother.
Brother John Rixroad, if everybody would stretch your hands this way, Lord, I'm thankful for my brother, who I have known for a minute. God, I'm thankful to be standing here on stage with this precious man who loves you, who has been faithful for you, God, who has been faithful to you. Lord, I thank you, God, that your anointing, oh, I thank you that your spirit not only lives in him, but it is upon him, for he has been anointed. I thank you, mighty God, that you have anointed him tonight, God, to bring forth a right now. I need somebody to say right now. A right now word for your people, God, and we come with great expectation in Jesus' mighty name. Now, God, our hearts are going to be open. Come on, I need a witness. Our ears are going to be receptive, God, and we're going to respond to the word that's delivered to us tonight and be thankful for it in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, amen. Nope, I said everybody said, amen. Amen, amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Brother Brad. Praise God. Praise God. Can we have these roll lights on here? My eyes is not too bright. I've got these pair right here, but them things, I still need some help from the lights too. From the light up above, but I need some help from this light too. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's so good to be in the house of the Lord tonight. I tell you what, we could go home right now. We could go home right now and say it's been good to be in the house of the Lord. Brother Brad told me, he told me the other day, we come out to practice last Saturday and stuff. Brother Brad told me, he said, Brother John, you may not get to preach. He said, God gets the mood and said, you may not even be able to preach. I said, hey, that don't bother me a bit. As long as the Holy Ghost is having his way, hey, I'm all for it. I am all for it. How many in here knows that's the truth? Hallelujah. I'm all for it. So that's the reason why we didn't come tonight to be seen. I know most of you in here worship with a bunch of you in here, stuff. And I tell you what, we had a great, great time while we was here. Got no regrets. I thank God for what he has done here, what he done when we was here, the way he moves and stuff. I'm not saying me. I'm saying God, the way God moves. But I'm thanking God that you all didn't die out and say, hey, that's far as we're going. That's all we're doing. I'm glad you guys is keeping on, keeping on. That's all God asks us to do, just keep on, keeping on. Somebody had told me, somebody made the statement. It was kind of funny. I tell you what, they didn't look like there's this many people in here, brother, when the light is out. Didn't look like there's as many people in here when the lights is out. I said, hey, this is all right. Now, they ain't that many people. And then when the lights come on, I'm like, whoa, here now. Wait a minute. Where'd all these people come from? But, hey, God is so good. But somebody made a statement to me and said, hey, I wonder if he'll get nervous while he's up there. I don't mind to tell you, I did it first, but hey, I've got the one that lives inside of me. I've got him on my side, and there's no nervousness needs to be about it. So hey, I'm just here tonight. Now I may not scream and holler. Hey, I'm all for that. If God's in it. If God's in it. I'm all for it. And I'm not the preacher that runs and cross back here and stuff like that, but I'm all for it. I just tell them, I say, hey, I preach the way God gives it to me. But I said, I'll tell you one thing. If God tells me to run around this building, I'll run around this building. If God tells me to run the back of these seats, I'll run them. But so far, God's not told me yet. Yet. Hey, I tell you what, God is so good. It's so good to look around here and see a lot of the faces and stuff and see a smiling face. You know, nobody likes to see somebody that's got a face looks like they've eaten 15 or 20 lemons. I mean, you know, hey, we like to have that smile on our face. And when we're up here, I know Brother Brad can say amen to that. When we're up here, we'd rather see a smile on your face. Because that tells us, hey, God's doing something in that one. God's doing something in that one. God's doing something in that. God's doing something in this church, too. Boy, that was awful weak. I said, God is doing something here in this church. And not only here is he doing something, he's doing something in Byrdstown. He's doing something in Moodyville. He's doing something out at Clark Range. God is doing something, and he wants his people to stand up and give God praise, because he's worthy of it all. He is worthy of all praise and all honor and all glory. He is worthy of it all, and he's deserving of it. I tell you what, God don't like these sad faces. You know, I heard my dad, you can be seated, but I heard my dad make a statement one time. He said it takes to frown. Now, we may have a health teacher in here somewhere tonight. If we do, you can correct me. But I believe he said that it takes like 350-some muscles in your face to frown. But it only takes 8 muscles in your face to smile. He said, there's no wonder God's people is dying at a young age. They're frowning themselves to death. They're frowning themselves to death. Hey, we ought to be the happiest people on this earth. We ought to be. Amen. We ought to be the happiest people on this earth. I want to recognize somebody. I tell you what, I love and appreciate every single person in here. I tell you what, this does my heart good. I told Brother Brad, I said, I can't wait. I said, we've just been so excited getting to come back home. Now we pastor down at Moodyville, but hey, it's always good to come back home too, to the home people. Hallelujah. We was here for 20-some year, I think it was, but God had another calling. God had another call, another place, another time. But he always brings us back. Oh, my. God is so good this night. Hallelujah. But I want to recognize, I want to give, the Bible says give honor. And, brother, I want to give you honor, and I want to thank you for having us to come and stuff and be here tonight. I want to thank you and thank Sister Julie and them for calling us and asking us to come. I tell you, it's a blessing to get to be here. It really is. But I want to give honor to a man here tonight. A man that I feel like my daddy's gone on. My dad's gone on out of this world. He's rejoicing in heaven. Oh, I know he is. He's rejoicing in heaven. He's having a time up there. And that's the reason why this brother. Would you come up here, brother? Brother Howard Daly. This man is one of my spiritual fathers. Yes, give him a hand. Give him a hand, everybody. Hallelujah. 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 If it hadn't have been for this little man right here, I don't know what I'd done. God used him to direct me when I got started. This man has more wisdom in him than I have ever seen in my lifetime. But God blessed you with that wisdom, brother. Oh, hallelujah. He told me the other day, he said, I feel like God has made me a, what on the wall did you say?
Watchman.
A watchman on the wall for you younger preachers to pray over. Man, I love that. I don't know about you, but I love somebody watching and praying over me. I love it, don't you, Brother Brad? I love it. But this little young man right here, hey, he is a blessing to me. I tell you what, sometimes he'll call me up on the phone. He'll say, Brother John, I just wanted to know how you're doing. I want to pray for you. Want to encourage you. I love that. I love that. You know, a lot of times we just need to call somebody, encourage them, uplift them. You know, they may be down and stuff, but say, hey, listen, God's got this. He's got it. They don't need to turn back. That's what I told him down at the church. I said, you can look back and see where you come from, but don't dwell back there. Amen. Don't dwell back there on that. Hallelujah. But I just want to thank God for this young man right here. And before I get into the word here tonight, I want everyone, if you would, I pray, every single person in here, point your hand toward this brother. He was telling me before service, he's got a shoulder here that's out of socket or something, and they're wanting to do surgery on it, but he don't want surgery done on it. But we know who the best surgeon is, and he don't leave no scar. So we're praying that the best surgeon does surgery on it right now. So lift your hands this way, please, and pray for Brother Howard. Oh, Father God, we just pray, Lord, right now, God, with this precious people. God, we're believing for total, complete healing, God, in this shoulder right now, Father. God, you made this shoulder, you made this arm, Father, and you made this body. And God, we're just believing right now that total, complete healing, Lord, is coming into this shoulder right now in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, Father, we believe it, Lord. You said where two or more would agree as touching any one thing, Lord, it shall be done. So we're just thanking you now, God, and praising you, Lord. It's done in Jesus' name. God, we've got enough people here, Lord, hallelujah, to remove any doubt at all. Oh, Father, God, I thank you, Father, God, for touching this man, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We just give you praise and thanks and praise for it all, God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you're doing it right now, God. You're working on this shoulder, Lord. In the name of Jesus, God, I believe the doctors is going to be amazed, Lord, when they see this shoulder again. They're going to be amazed, God, at what you have done, Father. Oh, we give you all of the praise and the honor and glory now. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
I receive that in Jesus' name. And God be the glory to everything. It's an honor to be here tonight. God bless you all.
Hallelujah. 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 We love Brother Howard. We love Brother Howard. If most of you was here, I think, for Dad's funeral. How many remembers being here at Dad's funeral? Oh, man, we didn't have no funeral. We had service, and that little young man right there, he preached that funeral. He preached that funeral, and hey, it wasn't none of these, well, poor little thing, he's gone on and left us and everything, and we'll meet him in the by and by one of these days. That brother right there, that's when I pass away, I hope he's still living, because I want that kind of message preached at my funeral. Hallelujah. Praise God. But that young man, he got happy and got up here and got happy preaching that funeral. And I'll tell you what, people was touched. They was touched. Hallelujah. God is so good. So good. All right. I'll get on in here. Hallelujah. Praise God. See what great things God has in store for us. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. God has been a-speaking. God's been a-working. Working, working, working. Hallelujah. If you want to turn with me, I'm going to read something here. And while you guys is turning, if you want to turn with me, we're going to be in Hebrews chapter 11. Start with verse 1. Yes, I love that. I love that. I forgot about that actually until you guys done that. I forgot about that. Man, that does me good though. Hallelujah. I'll never forget that Matt, what was it, Matt Gober? Gober? Come here and said and started that off. Oh man, it's went on all of these years. I tell you what, that does you good right there. Because that says, woo! That says, hey God, I'm ready to receive. I'm ready to receive something here tonight. Are you?
Yeah.
Well, about three or four of you sounded like. I'm ready to receive something here tonight. Are you?
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I like to hear right there. Okay, we're gonna go to Hebrews chapter 11, starting with verse 1, but I want to read something here right quick. I've got a book here by Brother Howard's nephew in Indiana, wrote this, Daily Devotion. And I got to reading it today, and I said, Lord, what do you want? And he said, read that. Read that to the people. Somebody here needs this. I don't know who you are, but I wasn't even aiming to read it. But God said, read it. There's somebody there that needs it. Somebody there that needs it. It says, advice to future men of God. When I think of my grandkids, and it names all of his grandkids, I certainly would want to give them some great advice that I believe will help them. My advice, seek out godly men. This is his grandsons. Seek out godly men so that you may become godly men. Proverbs 13:20. He that walketh with wise men shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Exodus 34:12. Listen, people, especially you young people. The devil is out to get you. And I'm not talking gloom and doom here today either, or here tonight. I'm not talking gloom and doom. I'm telling you the truth. The devil's after you because you've got something that he wants. And it's not you. He wants that anointing. He wants that anointing that you've got. When you stand up here and dance, when you come on Saturday nights, when you come on Sunday nights, when there's nobody here but you guys, the devil wants that anointing. Before I forget it, if it's all right with you, Brother Brad, before I forget it, if you guys can do it, I want that dry bones dance, if you all can still do it. If you can't, that's fine. But I was sitting right over there, and I think Brother Brad or somebody, there was two people mentioned about the dry bones. God had done spoke to me and said, asked them to do it. And then there was two other people mentioned dry bones. So if you guys can do it, I'd love it. If you don't, hey, we're going on for the Lord anyway. God is still God. God is still God. I love that dance over that you all had. Praise God. So be thinking about it if you can. If you can't, well, that's fine. Hallelujah. Getting back into our devotion here, Exodus 34:12, take heed to thyself, lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants, the unbelievers, of the land whither thou goest, lest it be for a snare in the midst of thee. There are forces all about us that try to mold our destiny, though forces are continual at work. They are not just around us, but they try to work their way within us. Whether you become good men, bad men, will be in many cases be determined by your alliances and your companionships and your friendships. These alliances will not only try to declare what you become, they will reveal what you are. Remember, each man is not only forming his own character for eternity, but also forming that of others. Each person you meet has the potential of leaving an impression. When we come in contact with men, be very careful, because we do not know what lasting impression or influence that we may leave upon us. As the Apostle Paul said to young Timothy, 1 Timothy 4:12, let no man despise thy youth, be thou an example. That's what God's wanting. He's wanting our young people and our old people and our middle-aged people to be an example. Like I told him at church this morning, he's not wanting a Sunday morning Christian. He's wanting one that'll live it 24/7. Too many people, and churches is not preaching it. Churches is not preaching it. Too many people wants to ride the fence. Let's see how far we can ride this fence. Brother, I believe this year that the fence is fixing to be broken down. It's fixing to be broken down. God is moving by his mighty power, and he's tired of people playing church. If you're playing church, stop it. Get up on the altar and pray. Get on the altar and pray if you're playing church. God is tired with these people playing church, being Sunday morning Christians and then living like the world the other 6 days. God don't like it, and it's fixing to stop. It's fixing to come to a halt. Now, that's for somebody. It's fixing to come to a halt because God says, look, I've spoke to people. I've talked to people. I've talked to them till he's blue in the face, as the saying is. He's talked and talked and talked. People's turned a deaf ear. I'll go on and live like I want to. You may live like you want to, but I'll tell you one thing. You will run up against a brick wall. I'm telling you, God is speaking in these last days, not to one church. He's speaking to all churches. And he's saying, listen, heed this warning. Heed this warning. Heed this warning, brother. We've got a lot of hypocrites in the church today. And that's what God's looking at. And he's just saying, look, it's time. Stop acting like something that you're really not. It's time you give God everything that you have. He's a blood brother to you. He's your God. He is your Father. But he's also blood brothers with you. How many of you in here knows what a blood brother is? That's what we are to God. And he says, what I have is yours. And you say, yes, yes, all right. What God has is mine. But whoa, whoa. What God has is yours, but what you have is God's. So that means that God wants all of you. He don't want part of you. He don't want most of you. He don't want 3/4 of you. He wants all of you. And that's what it's got. That's what it's all got to be about, is serving him, walking with him. Oh, my, I tell you what, it's a joy. It's a joy, brother. It's a joy to walk with the Lord. Hallelujah. I better get on in here. I'm not going to get this finished. Hallelujah. Says, as diamonds are ground best in their own powder, so men are best molded by men. Understand this principle. If you are not warm in the world, let me get this right. If you are not warm in the world is chilling you. And I heard a lot of grunts on that one, but that's the truth. That's the truth. There are two ways by which you equalize the temperature of a hotter and colder body. One is by the hot one getting cold, and the other is by the cold getting hot. Here's the conclusion. If you are not warm in the world, then the world is freezing you. How many got that? It went over some of his heads. I ain't kidding you. I felt it. It went right over some of his heads. If you are not warm in the world, then the world is freezing you. It has been said our association with unholy people will either make them desire to be holy or us to be unholy. So which way, I ask you tonight, which way is it in your life? Which way is it in your life? I'm just preaching straight right out of this word of God. Hallelujah. How is it in your life, God says? Our association with unholy people will either make them desire to be holy. You're going to show them the love of God and the grace of God, or else they'll show you the world and win you to the world. That's something to think on. I certainly cannot overemphasize the importance of godly influence. And says, the reason if you find a man that follows the above pattern, I know you would be cared for. God will see it. God will see it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, we're going to get down in here. Hebrews chapter 11, starting with verse 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. You know, I was reading that this evening, and I wanted to go back over here to Romans 8 and 24 says, for we are saved by hope, but hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why doth he yet hope for? But if we hope for that we see not, then do we, with the patience, wait for it. For by it the elders obtain, back to Hebrews verse number 2, for by it the elders obtain a good report. Through faith, understand that the words were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were made of things which do not appear. God wants us to have faith. Oh, hallelujah. If you've got faith, you can speak to the mountain. We've got a young girl, I don't know where she is. There she is. Sister Tracy sings a song. Speak to the mountain. It don't matter how big the mountain is, Brother Brad. You know, a lot of people says, oh, I've got too big of a mountain for God to take care of. You don't have too big of a mountain for God to take care of. He can take care of anything. Anything. All we got to do is speak in faith. Speak in the name of Jesus. Speak in the name of Jesus. Tom, Joe, Bob, Shorty, Harry, none of those names will work. They won't work. They won't work, Brother Bob. You got to speak the name of Jesus. And when you speak the name of Jesus, you've spoken the key that unlocks. Unlocks it all. You've unlocked the key to death, hell, and the grave. When you speak in faith and walk in faith, oh my. I know there's a song I believe we used to sing here at the church and stuff. I walk by faith. I walk by faith. I can't sing, but I love to do that. But hey, God has, he's been speaking to me here the last week and stuff. I'm John. Like I said, I'm not one that hollers and screams and stuff, but if God ever anoints me to do that and moves on me to do it, you'll hear me do it. But hey, I like to do what God wants me to do. Whatever he has me to do, that's what I want to do. Hallelujah. Verse 4 says, by faith Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it being dead yet speaketh. By faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death. Oh, my, what a testimony there. Now, that's a testimony. Praise God. And was not found because God had translated him before his translation. He had this testimony that he pleased God. Oh, my, I want to please God tonight, don't you? I want to please God tonight. In everything I do, I want to please God. I want to praise God for everything that he blesses me with. Every time he anoints me to speak, every time he blesses me to get up out of that bed, brother, I thank God. Hey, Lord, you give me another day. You give me another day. Praise God. Praise God. Verse 6, but without faith it is impossible to please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. That's just like the college up the road here, there in Kentucky. God's rewarding those young people because they're saying, hey, here I am, Lord. He's going to reward some churches. He's the same God. What I told somebody today, brother, he's the same God here. He's the same God on this platform as he is right there in that college up there in Kentucky. People running, and that's fine. That's fine. That they wanting to go and see that, that's great. I'm all for it. But, hey, people, listen. He's the same God right here. The one that's moving there, he's moving here, too. He's everywhere. He's everywhere. Like the little song they used to sing for Christmas, he's everywhere. He's everywhere. Hey, the Holy Ghost is everywhere. Hallelujah. So what he's doing there, he can do here, but he's looking for somebody that's going to believe him, somebody that's going to have faith and say, God, you can do it, and you will do it, Lord, and I'm trusting in you, God, to do it, Father. That's all he's looking for is a willing, able, believing vessel is what he's looking for. Hallelujah. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he demanded the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. He spoke in faith because it hadn't rained for hundreds and hundreds, hadn't even rained or nothing. And he spoke by faith and got made fun of. That's what in these last days, brother, God's ministers are going to get made fun of because the world thinks they're crazy. He says, oh, you're crazy. You're a nut. You're a nut. You're standing up there talking about God and stuff like that. You're a nut. But they done Moses and them like that too. But what did they do when the door got shut and sealed within and without? Sealed within and out. What did they do then when the raindrops started sprinkling? People, what is that? What is that? What's happening here? A little bit harder. Hey, we never have seen this before. What's going on here? Never had seen this. Started raining a little bit harder and harder and harder. Finally, it started raining so hard, the water started coming up. Then it started coming up from the ground, and it was coming up from the ground and coming down from the air. But Moses' family got saved because Moses was listening. Moses was listening. You know, that's what I've been telling people. I said, listen, when I get down to pray, I ask God, God, anoint my ears that I may hear. Everything, God, that you want these ears to hear, I pray they hear it, Father. Everything that you want these eyes to see, you anoint them, Lord, to see. Everything you want this mouth to speak, you anoint these lips and anoint this tongue. And we'll speak it. And everywhere you want our feet to trod and our legs to go, you point us in the right direction. You anoint us and give us the will, the strength to do it and to go, and we'll go. God's looking for people. He's not looking for somebody that says, hey, right here I am, right here I am, and then you walk from here to that back there where that camera's at and then give up. A lot of people's doing that right now. They're getting weary. A lot of people getting weary. I'm not preaching a down and defeated message. I'm preaching to you the truth tonight. The truth, just like this man right here. Every Sunday and every Wednesday night, this man preaches the truth. And I've been in service with him ever since he was small and stuff. I know God is using him. I know God has anointed him and stuff. So I know what he's preaching. I know it's the truth. Hallelujah. Thank God for men of God like this. Men of God like Brother Howard. Men of God like Brother Darrell. Men of God like Brother Jamie now. All of these men and other ministers in here. Brother I can't even think of your name now. Brother out here. Daniel. Brother Daniel. Brother Daniel. Looking straight at him, and I couldn't place his name. But God is looking. And he's speaking. Look, I have a work for you to do. Yes. That's an amen, isn't it? Amen. He has a work for you to do. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. See there, I got God on my side, ain't I? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know it ain't the devil, because the devil don't hang around in here. He's done gone out of here, so I know it wasn't the devil. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Verse 8, by faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should, after receiving inheritance, obeyed, and he went out not knowing whither he went. Verse 9, by faith he sojourned in the land of promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. The same promise. You know, we have the same promise as they did back then. We've got that same promise that they preached back then, that they walked after and went after back then. We've got that same promise. We need to get up and go after it, Brother Daniel. Too many people being too lazy. I ain't kidding you. And Brother Brad, when he called me and asked me, he didn't say, well, you know, don't preach too hard or anything, or don't preach on nobody or something like that. He just asked me to come and preach, and I said, hey, I'll do it. And that's a real, you know, hey, I'm not here to cut corners. I'm not here to, as your dad used to say, rub the cat. I never will forget that, him doing that. I never will forget that. Hey, if you're being rubbed like that, what was he said? Turn it around and, hey, there you go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'll never forget that little illustration he done. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. By the way, while I'm speaking to him too, he needs prayer tonight, because Brother Brad told me before service that he's sick and had a temperature and stuff. So when we get through ministering here and stuff, I want us, if Brother Brad don't care, I want us to pray for Brother Dale, because they said he was sick, said he had a temperature and everything. So let's pray for him after we get through with the message here. Hallelujah. Verse 10, for he looked for a city which hath foundations, whose builder and maker is God. Hallelujah. Through faith also Sarah herself received strength to conceive. Abby Jo. Through faith also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed, and was delivered a child when she was past her age, because she judged him faithful who had promised. Sis, you've been faithful. God's seen that faithfulness too. Don't listen to what the devil tries to tell you. It's coming your way, sis. It's coming your way. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes. It's coming your way. That baby's coming your way. Hallelujah. 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 No matter what doctors say, he's the one that has the last word. He's the one that has the last say. So that's what we're believing and trusting in. Hallelujah. Praise God. Therefore sprang there even of one, and him as good as dead, so many as other, the stars in the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the seashore, innumerable. Hallelujah. These all died in faith, not having received the promises. Now listen. But having seen them afar off, they seen it, and they wanted it, and they desired to be in our day. They desired to be in our day because they seen the promises. They know the promises were straight ahead, not back behind us. Don't go back there. There's nothing to go back to, people. I'm telling you, there is nothing to go back to right here, back here. Oh, hallelujah. Everything we need to keep going for is right straight ahead. Don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. God says, hey, I'm leading you. I'm guiding you. I'm teaching you if you'll let me teach you. Too many people are hard-headed. They won't let God teach them. But if you let God teach you and lead you, he'll lead you and teach you in the right direction at every time, turning point. God will do it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For they that such things declare plainly that they seek a country. I'm almost done here. Hallelujah. And truly, if they had been mindful of that country from whence they came out, they might have had an opportunity to return. I'm going to jump down to 17. By faith, Abraham, when he was tried, offered up Isaac. And he that had received the promises offered him up his only begotten son. That's what God is asking his people. I want your best. People wants to give him leftovers. Leftovers. I mean, I like to eat pinto beans leftovers. But anything else? Mm-mm. I love pinto beans. And I like to eat them if they're left over. I love that, warm back up and stuff. But a lot of this other stuff, I don't like it. I'd rather have fresh meat. Fresh. Fresh. That's what God, I was hoping Sister Barb would be here tonight. I don't see her here, but I was hoping she'd be here. She wrote a song, Fresh Far. Fresh Far. God is speaking 2023. He's wanting to give fresh far to his people. Fresh far to his saints. Fresh far. How many of us in here tonight would lift your hand and say, hey, I want the fresh far? About half, there we go. Majority, yes. God wants to give it. No, if you want it bad, God wants it even worse than you do for you to have it. He wants you to have it. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Verse 19, accounting that God was able to raise him even from the dead, from whence also he received him in a figure. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. By faith, Jacob, when he was a dying, blessed both the sons of Joseph and worshiped, leaning on the top of his staff. By faith, Joseph, when he died, made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandments concerning his bones. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw he was a proper child, and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. By faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. A lot of people wants to be called the son of God. But a lot of people don't want to live it. That's the reason why I've heard different ministers already this year. God is fixing to clean the fence off. He's fixing to clean the fence off. I'm telling you, when we see these people just trying to live any old way and think they're going to make it in, that Bible does not lie. And it said hell had to enlarge its border to take them all in that's going there. I don't want to see no more go than anyone else does. So that's the reason why we've got to be praying. We've got to be reaching out. Reaching out. Hallelujah to people. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. It's so easy to minister in here tonight, brother. I'll tell you what it is. It's a joy. I mean, it's so easy. Praise God. Praise God. All right, I'm about done here, I promise you. By faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. Through faith he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of the blood, lest he that destroyed the firstborn should touch them. By faith they passed through. They didn't get stuck when that right out there in the middle of that mud and all that stuff. I don't know how they done it. Well, God done it. I do know how they done it. God done it. Dried that sea up and stuff so they could go right across through there. And then Pharaoh's army come right in behind them and every one of them Hey, that's the reason why I said God. That's the reason why God says, let me fight you battles. If you'll let me fight you battles. Now, that was for somebody. That was for somebody. God says, listen, let me fight you battles, and I'll take care of every one of them. If you'll let me work it. If you'll let me work it. I don't need no help. I don't need your help in this. You let me work it. Turn it all over to me. People wants to turn half over to him. They don't want to turn the whole thing. They want to turn half. Here you go, God. Work in this. And the whole time God said, no, 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 no. No. I want 100%. You give me 100%, and I'll show you what I can do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. By faith, the walls of Jericho fell down after they were compassed about 7 days. By faith, the harlot Rahab perished not with them that believed not when she had received the spies with peace. God had favor on her. The men had favor. When they was going in to take the city, she said, here, I'll hide you. But when I hide you, I want favor with you because I don't want my family destroyed. I don't want to be destroyed, but I don't want my family to be destroyed too. And when they come, they had the ones inside, her home was took care of. And that's what God wants to do to you. Get in safety. Get in safety. Get in safety. Get in God. Hallelujah. He wants to take care of his people. Hallelujah. I feel like that right there is where God. But God is speaking to a church. Not only alive in the spirit, not only love and grace, not only the church over here or the church down the road. He's speaking where anybody will let him move. If you say, hey, how many of you in here tonight wants to be used of God? Oh, yes, yes, yes. I love that. I love that. Then God wants to use you. So you've made a vow tonight. Every person in here that raised their hand, you made that vow tonight. Hey, I want God to use me. God wants to use you. He will use you. Get everything in order. Because like I told them the other night, God will not put new wine in an old bottle. If you've got sin in that bottle, this bottle, this earthly flesh, this bottle, you've seen when people get ready to do canning and stuff, the lady, she'll get in there and she'll clean them jars out and she'll scour around and scald them jars real good and clean and clean and clean and clean and get them jars real good and clean before she puts stuff in there. You wouldn't want to eat stuff if you seen somebody just putting an old nasty jar up there and just pour tomato juice or pour green beans or something in there. Like you wouldn't want to do that, would you? You wouldn't want to eat that. I wouldn't. I wouldn't want to eat it at all, brother. But that's what God's saying. He's saying, eat. Look, the world is eating the nasty junk. The world is eating the nasty. Let me, God says, let me clean you up. When he cleans you up and cleans you all out, then you're ready. And then you can say, hey, Lord, pour that Holy Ghost in me. Pour that Holy Ghost in me. Because he wants to do it more than anything. He wants to do it. Hallelujah. Bow your heads with me tonight. Father God, tonight, Lord, God, we just want to thank you so much for this precious, precious people, God, that we have got, that we have had the privilege and the blessing, God, to be able to come. Lord, we thank you so much for Brother Brad and Sister Julie, for them asking us to come and minister, God. I thank you, Lord, for this precious couple, for this precious pastor and his wife, Lord. and his congregation. God, I thank you so much for each and every church, God, that is representing here tonight, God. And we've got more than four or five different churches that is representing here tonight, God. And I thank you for each and every single one of them here tonight, Father. God, I pray a blessing up over their churches, up over their pastors. And God, I pray that every church here tonight has heard this message, Lord, they'll take it back to their congregation, God. And Lord, that they will minister the truth. God, not a shortcut, not a way around something, not bypassing something that you want brought to their congregation, Lord. But God, I pray, anoint every pastor here tonight, God, that is here, Father, that represents their church. God, I pray you would anoint them and bless them. God, move in a great and awesome, mighty way. Bless their church, Lord. Oh, Father, God, I pray that they will see their attendance jump, Lord. Jump, God, because they're opening to you, Father, and saying, come in, Lord, and sup with us, Father, and dine with us, God. We want you to come in and dine with us and sup with us. Oh, Father, God, we trust you. We want to put our full trust, and walk therein today. Oh, Father, God, I thank you for reaching everyone here tonight, God. I pray if there is anyone here tonight, God, that may be lost, that doesn't know you, Lord, I pray, God, that they will come to know you tonight, Father, that they'll not leave like they came in Jesus' name. And, God, I pray if there's any sick here among us, Lord, God, I pray right now for each and every one that may be sick, that may have a cold or cough or something wrong, may any kind of sickness. Father God, you're the healer, Lord. So we're believing, God, tonight that you're going to do it. You're going to touch them and heal them, Lord, I pray. Hallelujah. Keep your head bowed and your eyes closed, please. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I didn't ask Brother Brad how he wanted to do this, but hallelujah. Keep your head bowed and your eyes closed, please. Please, no looking around, please. Is there anyone in here tonight that you want to lift your hand and say, hey, I need prayer tonight. I'm not as close to the Lord as I need to be. I want to get closer to him. Or if you're not saved, you want to lift your hand and say, hey, I want to come to know that man that you've been talking about tonight. I want to know him on a personal basis in my life. Is there anyone here tonight with all heads bowed and all eyes closed? Please, please, please. Don't look around. Please. Is there anyone here tonight you want to raise your hand and say, please pray for me? Yes, I see that hand. I see that hand. I see that hand and that one and that one. Yes. Yes. Oh, Father God. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, you've seen these hands tonight, God. You've seen these hands that's been lifted, Lord. Oh, Father God. Anyone else want to join these? Hallelujah. Anyone else want to raise your hand and join these that needs prayer? Yes, I see that hand. I see that hand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. God is moving. God is moving. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anyone else want to join us in this word of prayer? Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Yes. Yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, keep your head bowed and your eyes closed. Father God, we just come to you once again here now, Lord. God, we just ask you've seen every hand that was raised here tonight, God, signifying, Lord, hey, I either need you, God, I've got something in my life that's clogging me up, that's keeping me, Lord, away from you and keeping me getting closer to you. So, God, I need that hindrance moved out of my way. God, I need this sin out of my life, Father. You see the sin, Lord, because you have an all-seeing eye. And you know, God, what we do each and every day, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. God, I just pray for these ones that may be lost and they're wanting to come back or wanting to come and repent and call out to you, Lord. Are these ones that may be grown cold, Lord, and needs to get closer to you, Father. God, I pray for them this night, Lord. Do it, God. Do it, Lord, I pray. God, save them, Lord. And God, the ones that's grown cold, Lord, God, bring them back, Father. God, I pray that they'd come back and get closer, get up to the fire, God. Because these last days, Lord, that's what it's going to take, is getting closer to the fire, getting that fresh fire down in us, and letting it work, God, like you want it to, Father. We just pray now and we ask it all and thank you for it all. In Jesus' most holy name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. You just keep your heads bowed and eyes closed. Dear Heavenly Father, I bless you and I thank you, God. Lord, thank you for the precious move of your Spirit. Thank you for that word. Come on, I need a witness. Thank you for that word. Thank you for Brother John. God, thank you for the time that he spent seeking your face, God. Lord, I thank you that it's challenged and God encouraged the body of Christ tonight. And we just give you the glory and we give you the praise in Jesus' mighty name. If I could just do something right where everybody, just keep your heads bowed and eyes closed right now. And you say, Pastor Brad, I was one of those that Pastor John was speaking to a minute ago. I lifted my hand. I don't want you to leave here without a doubt, without a question. I want to pray with you. We're going to pray together a prayer of faith. And you're going to speak words that you believe in your heart and you confess it with your mouth and you're going to leave this place saved, set free, washed in the blood of the Lamb right now. So let's just pray together. Come on, every church, every person here, let's pray with them. Let's support them and know, hey, we're with you. We're praying with you. We got your back. Let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, I come to you tonight in the name of your Son, Jesus. Lord Jesus, I surrender my heart. Just like the word I heard tonight. Not part of it. Not a piece of it. All of it. I give all of me to you tonight. I turn from my past and I turn to you. I repent. Forgive me of my sins. Lord Jesus, I believe you died on the cross for me. I believe you took stripes on your back for my healing. I'm thankful that you took a crown of thorns on your head that I could have peace of mind. Lord, I'm thankful that you were nailed to that cross, suspended between heaven and earth, a spotless lamb that was the sacrifice for my sins. You took my place. And tonight I say thank you. You gave your life for me. You were placed in a borrowed tomb. But 3 days later, you rose again. And you're alive right now. And you hear my prayer. So tonight, come into my heart. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' mighty name, I am forgiven. By faith, I confess it. I believe it in my heart. I have been forgiven. I'm no longer lost, but I am on my way to heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Everybody said, give God some praise. Come on. If you raised your hand tonight, you prayed a prayer by faith, and don't let the devil tell you, no, it didn't mean something. It meant, come on, I need to, it meant something. I believed it in my heart, and I confessed it with my mouth. Plus, his word says, whosoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. So, Father, I thank you for this night of worship. Thank you for this night in your presence. God, I just give you the glory and I give you the praise. If you've got a need in this house tonight, whether it's physical, financial, relationship, whatever the need is, the brother just told you, God is more than enough to meet it. He'll move whatever mountain, come on, to straighten the thing out. We talked about that this morning. That's the kind of God I serve. And he'll straighten it out for you. He'll make every valley high, every mountain low, come on. And every crooked path straight, and he'll make a way in this situation. If you've got a need, just slip your hand up in the air right now by faith. Yeah, if you see a hand go up, just place your hand on the shoulder of that person next to you. Get in agreement right now. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you that you are more than enough. Lord, I thank you that you're meeting every need according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Right now, God, if it's healing right now, in Jesus' mighty name, I loose that spirit of life. I loose that spirit of healing right now in Jesus' mighty name. And I bind that spirit of infirmity. Right now, sickness, you must bow your knee to the name that's above every name. We plead the blood of the Lamb right now. Lord, your word says in the book of Jeremiah, save me and I shall be saved. Heal me and I shall be healed, for thou art my praise. We declare that right now over every situation. God, you're more than enough. I thank you and I bless you. Thank you, mighty God. I bless you. Jehovah Jireh, the one who sees and provides right now, God, moving like only you can by the power of your spirit. Come on, I need a witness. Not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. Right now, receive by faith. And we give you the glory and we give you the praise in your mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. God is good all the time. And all the time. I said, my God is good. And all the time. My God is good. Man, I see some guys from different churches. Where's Brother Shaver? Are you still here somewhere? Yeah, right there. There's two or three of them. I don't know. They've multiplied since service. I don't know. Guys, we're so... Oh, there you are. There you, okay. God bless you guys from Clark Range out there. Come on, everybody give them a big hand. So glad. Come on, I see Upward Church back there. Come on, we'll give them... Hi, we love you guys. Love you guys. God bless you. Thank you for coming. God bless you. Good Shepherd Church, it's always a blessing to see you guys here. We love you all. We love you all. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Anybody else? Did I miss anybody? Somebody? Line of Spirit? Oh. I need to hear from the faithful. Come on. I need to hear from Aliveness Spirit. We're so glad that you're here tonight. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you, dear Heavenly Father. Well, I'm going to close in a word of prayer. I don't... Love and Grace? Did I not say Love and Grace? You got to say something? Yeah, okay. Love and Grace, we're thankful that you guys are here. John, thank you for letting them come. God bless you guys. God bless you. Thank you, mighty God. Let's just pray for Pastor Dale Cox right now. Lord, I thank you, God, that you're bringing healing life into his body. I bless you and I praise you, mighty King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I thank you that you are his healer right now, that your anointing be loosed in his body, burden removing, yoke destroying, power of God. I pray right now, Lord, that you're touching him, healing him, raising that man of God up right now, God, making him every whit whole from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your body that was broken for his healing. God, we declare it right now. We believe to receive, Lord, that he is receiving that healing and that life and that strength in his body right now. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Love and Grace, thank you for being here. Did I say that already? Okay. Thank you, Love and Grace, for being here. No, it is. It's good to see you guys. Thank you all. Everyone that came tonight, thank you for coming to our Fire by Night service. We love you. Be blessed in the Lord in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you.